In this video, I'm going to discuss about the common mistakes that we do during deposits and how we can prevent them. So by the end of this video, you should be able to prevent losses and make a perfect deposit. What are these common mistakes during deposit? Now, the most common mistake during deposit is sending to a wrong number, sending extra amount of money, and also sending money without being given the cash actually. But what is deposit? Let us first talk about what is deposit in actual sense. Deposit is the type of mobile money transaction where a customer gives you cash and then you are supposed to put electronic money offload in his or her account. So in doing that, there are very many different mistakes that these agents do that lead them into losses. So this is what we are going to discuss in this video, so that you don't make any other loss when you follow these steps. So by the end of this video, I'm going to be discussing 3 steps that you should be taking while making any deposit, so that you don't make losses. If you are one who is operating mobile money, or you are interested in mobile money business, please subscribe to this channel, because we are going to be giving you tips and tricks of how to succeed in mobile money business, and also we shall be making videos of how to start a successful mobile money business right on this channel. So let's jump into some of the mistakes that you do during deposit. The first mistake that you do during deposit is sending to a wrong number. This is in a case where a customer comes to request for a money to be sent or deposited on his or her account, then a customer misfires, or even the agent can do that by mistake, sends to a wrong number. So this happens so often in the country, and so those are very, very, very vital things that we should take control of. When you actually deposit a lot of money, you also lose your own money, and when you deposit less money, you are losing customers. So customers and that money is very, very important to you, that you need to do very hard so that you can keep them. So another thing is that you are trying to send actually money, yet someone has not given you money. Someone comes, send for me this amount of money, let me get the money in the car, and then someone drives the car and goes away. So you have sent your money without being given the cash. All these are problems that agents are facing, but can we follow these 3 steps so that we can prevent at least some of these common ones? Remember, on this very channel, we are going to be posting about tricks of mobile money and updates, and also we shall be giving you the tips of really succeeding in this business. So make sure you follow this channel, subscribe to this channel, and turn on the notification button so that you'll be following all the videos on this channel. So let's go to the 3 steps. Step number 1, receive first. At mobile money agents, we always encourage, and our motto is receive first. So if you are going to do a deposit, what are you going to receive? You are going to receive cash. Make sure you receive that cash first. So that is our first step. When you receive the cash first, count that money. How much have you received? That I've received 100,000. If it's 100, well and good. If it's 1 million, well and good. Now, if you have received 100,000, you have counted it is 100,000, you ask the customer that you have given me 100,000. If the customer accepts that, yes, I've given you, and make sure when you're counting this money, don't count it under the drawer or behind where the customer is not seeing. Make sure you receive the money before you put the money out of the customer's eye. Count it so that you agree with the customer the amount of money he or she has given you. So after doing that, you pick your record book. That record book is very, very important to you customers, and make that is your lawyer actually at the point. So make sure you have your record book. So before doing a transaction for the customer, a deposit, pick your record book. Now you have received 100,000. Write the amount that I have received, 100,000. Where are we going to deposit this money? To this customer's account. Let the customer read the number. So when the customer reads the number, 07809925 90, so the customer writes the number, you write the customer's number where you are depositing the money. Then you ask the customer that what name will it bring for me. So you write the name. You are doing this before you have picked your phone. You are doing this before you have picked your phone. So it is even advisable to put your phone down away from you, so that you pull out the phone when you are sure of what you are going to do. So you have recorded this on your transaction book. Pull out the drawer, remove your phone. You have now removed your phone. You already know that this is the number, this is the amount, this is the name that I'm depositing this amount. Press the old phone gently. Don't allow don't allow a customer to put you on pressure. Press your phone gently. Make sure you press that exact number that you have given, and make sure you press that exact amount. So our first step is receiving first. The next step is record the amount you have received. So the last step that you should follow is, this is the last step that you should follow. The last step is, do not put in your PIN before you confirm these three things. Do not put in your things before you confirm these three things. What are these things that we are talking about? The three things that we are talking about is, one, the amount of money you are depositing. Before you put in your PIN, check the amount of money you are depositing. Two, check the date and time. But the most important thing, the second one we talk about, is checking the type of transaction. Most people undermine the type of transaction. That no, let me, I can actually do it without, so long as I've seen that it is bringing, the name is Jibril, so that is the name Jibril. No, check the type of transaction, because you are doing a deposit of 100,000, you may end up selling airtime instead of deposit of 100,000. You may end up actually sending a withdrawal request instead of depositing 100,000. So make sure you check the deposit, the type of transaction. Make sure you check the amount of transaction, and finally make sure you confirm the customer's details, that is the customer's name. So the three things that you are supposed to confirm before putting in your PIN are, one, you have to confirm the amount of transaction. Two, you have to confirm the names of the customer or the details of the customer. And then the last one, you are supposed to confirm the amount, the type of transaction that you are doing, that indeed I'm doing a deposit of how much, 100,000, and it is going to Jibril. So what you do, you deposit that amount of money, then you put in your PIN. If you have confirmed that, it means now you have already done the transaction. Your message will come back and the rest will be history. Would have prevented losses like, I have sent to a wrong number, I have sent extra amount of money, I have sent amount the money, but he has not given me the money. Those are losses that we can prevent by following these three steps that I have discussed. So on this very channel, we are going to be discussing very many types of transactions. We're going to discuss tips and tricks of mobile money, and then how you can start a successful mobile money business, plus updates of mobile money, all together on this very channel. So subscribe to this channel that you don't miss any of such information. Thank you so much. I've been Jibril. Nice time.